Welcome to Real Reviews, where we invite you to experience film through the eyes of a true film addict. This week's reviews are brought to you by thefilmgordon.com. I am Tim Gordon, editor-in-chief of The Film Gordon, and on this show, we discuss my views on upcoming films. Now, you can also read or listen to past reviews on either thefilmgordon.com, Spreaker, Spotify, iTunes, Google, or various social media aspects or platforms. Now, this week on the show, we discuss Outside the Wire, which is a sci-fi film directed by Mikael Hastrom, and it stars Anthony Mackie, who serves as a producer in the film, as an android officer who works with a drone pilot played by Damson Idris to stop a global catastrophe. Now, the film is scheduled for release by Netflix on January the 15th, so it'll be on the platform this weekend. Now, the story begins in the year 2036, where war is raging, and a strong-willed drone pilot, Lieutenant Hart, played by Idris, disobeys a direct order from his superiors, resulting in the death of two Marines and a government-fighting robot known as a Gump. Now, instead of facing a court-martial, Lieutenant Harp is reassigned to a fighting unit under the mysterious Captain Leo, played by Mackie, to give him a bird's eye view of the carnage that he witnesses from the quiet of the command center where he works dishing out judgment and chaos. Now, as he receives his final instructions, he's simply warned he's not like us, which would be the beginning of Harp's season of discontent. Now, after initially rubbing his superior officer, Captain Leo, the wrong way, he also discovers that his earlier warning would introduce him to a fourth generation bio being that appears human on the outside, but is a machine underneath. Now, Leo brings his human counterpart along on what initially is a mission to dispense meds to sick people outside the militarized zone, known as Outside the Wire, but of course, there's much more to Leo than meets the eye. Now, while Mackie gets top billing for his extensive filmography, including his work on films such as The Banker, The Hurt Locker, and his work in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, it is Idris who really shines in this film. Playing another variation of his character, Franklin Saint, on, on Snowfall, once again, Idris is a quietly, overly confident character who seems detached, but is locked in on everything around him until he's not. Now, the young British actor has quite a future ahead of him, and it will be interesting to see how he expands his filmography into other genres. Now, Hafstrom's screenplay blends standard battle content mixed with the usual suspects-esque elements, which produce an entertaining story, which works largely because of both Mackie and Idris. Now, Outside of the Wire reminds me from an action standpoint of last summer's Netflix breakout hit, The Old Guard, as a pleasant surprise. Now, while Mackie gives his standard all-around solid performance, Idris is the one to watch and is wonderful to experience his star-making growth coming right in front of our eyes. I gave Outside the Wire a C+. It's not a perfect film. It's a film that would be forgettable if not for the work of its two leads. So that's my real review of this film. As I said, it is on Netflix this weekend, the 15th of January. You guys enjoy, and we will definitely see you on the other side. Enjoy your day.